There seems to be a fine line between coincidence and irony.
You sure about that map?
Unfortunately, there was some nonsense about the discovery of the real King Arthur's tomb here years ago, soon discredited. And yet another roadside attraction was born.
Well, let's see what we can see, shall we? At least it should be educational. Either housekeeping should be fired, or no one's been inside for months. This place has seen better days.
It's been condemned since the death of the owner, one Professor Worth. I shudder to think that at one time he had students.
They must be electric. I'll have to find the power main.
The place is locked up pretty tight on the ground floor. Probably have to try up higher.
And we have power. Difference between stupid and charming with you, is there?
So that there would be no squabbling betwixt ye knights, Merlin bequeathed upon Arthur yon round table, which was the table neither square nor buttressed, but circular in form. 'Twas a symbol of unity and equality, and 'twas from whither Arthur's knights took their name, the Knights of the Round Table.
I'm assuming you're taking notes.
Yeah, verily.
Thus didst King Arthur gather round his person ye greatest knights of ye realm, that they might be paragons of chivalry and virtue. Gaily they camest, yea, and 'twas an assembly as hadst not before been seen of, and verily there was much rejoicing.
Hey, push the button again. It's like electroshock therapy for Alice there.
I like to think it keeps him sharp.
Thank you. And yea, ye sword could ne'er be broken. What was its magic?
I'm confused. Weren't Excalibur and the Sword in the Stone the same thing? They were two bloody different swords!
Now, Zip, that was too easy.
Then did Merlin fall in love with Nimue, to whom he did teach us his magics. But ere long, she didst use her magics against her lover, imprisoning him. Wherefore it was that when Arthur didst do battle with Mordred, Merlin couldst not protect of him. It seemeth that oft times ye wisest of men canst maketh mistakes.
It was his own fault, really.
Never trust a woman?
Don't believe in magic.
For hours did Arthur and Mordred hackle upon Salisbury Plain. Arthur with Excalibur, Mordred with its scabbard. Then it was that both were disarmed, and Arthur did strike Mordred a fatal blow with the spear of Sir Bedivere. Anon came more tragedy, for Arthur was himself mortally wounded in evil.
Maybe the grunting Saxon or the Roman fascist that Alistair believes the whole legend was built around. This is where the truth behind the myth is supposed to be explained. It has been turned into a warehouse.
Fitting. There's been so little truth everywhere else. Why start here? The only factual basis behind the King Arthur myths died centuries before this place was built.
Give Professor Worth some credit. If he had to close an exhibit for renovations, at least he picked the most boring one. This definitely isn't Arthur's tomb.
We knew that already.
What's wrong with it?
I've seen enough tombs in my life to know when I'm looking at a cenotaph.
Say who?
A diversion. This place is trying too hard. It's hiding something.
A body?
No, that's the problem. That's fragile.
Nice. Be don't want to demolish anything important.
Really, Alistair, I have a velveteen touch. But I'm glad to see you now think there may be something important here. Please, Alice. Please, Alistair. This will take some concentration.
Yeah, pipe down, Alistair. Or I won't let you sit up front with me anymore.
So am I.
That doesn't mean you don't have to be quiet anymore. Looks like there's oil seeping into the water table. Who knows how long it's been burning?
I wonder if the architect's design deliberately took this into account.
There's your answer, Alistair.
Wow. You know you're gonna ruin your boots.
Not on the path I'll need to take.
Looks like there's oil seeping into the water table. Who knows how long it's been burning?
I wonder if the architect's design deliberately took this into account.
There's your answer, Alistair.
Wow. You know you're gonna ruin your boots.
Not on the path I'll need to take.
Looks like there's oil seeping into the water table. Who knows how long it's been burning?
I wonder if the architect's design deliberately took this into account.
There's your answer, Alistair.
Wow. You know you're gonna ruin your boots.
Not on the path I'll need to take.
Looks like there's oil seeping into the water table.
Maybe there's a way up and over.
It
might have been worth trying just to hear you lads squeal about it. have been worth trying just to hear you lads squeal about it.
Place, sir.
If we're through having fun, it's time to get back to business. Will you look at that? Oh, this is brilliant.
That is interesting.
Hmm. We're looking at myth, except it's real. They're all here, the court of Camelot.
You're sure about this? King Arthur, who wast verily of ye loins of Usurpendragon?
I've no doubt about the authenticity of this tomb, Alistair. Arthur was the 11th century figure that became legend. The once and future king was as real then as the air I'm breathing now.
I don't know, Lara.
Excalibur. The sword in the stone. That's how it always goes, isn't it?
Pardon?
Swords in stones, Alistair. They're part of the monomyth. There wasn't just one Excalibur or one Merlin. We keep seeing swords and daises all over the world because they were everywhere.
So you're saying that everywhere they went, they raised up kings, shaping the course of human destiny?
Well, it's a possibility.
Who? And what happened to them and their swords?
Perhaps they're in Avalon. It's as good a place as any. Except our Merlin was killed and our Excalibur was left in pieces in the hands of the locals.
So where's Avalon?
I don't know. On the other side of the looking glass, perhaps?